Hello, I'm Graham and I hope everyone's having a great day. Welcome to part 6 in this new video tutorial series looking at basic photography using Panasonic Lumix bridge cameras. Now today's subject is about flash. Now light is so crucial to getting good exposures in our photography. So what can we do if that light is inadequate or our subject isn't being lit to its best advantage? So the answer is to provide our own illumination in the form of electronic flash. And in this video, I'll be showing you how to use both the pop-up flash, externally mounted flash guns on the hot shoe, and externally triggered flash guns using either optical trigger or radio trigger. By enhancing or totally overriding the ambient light, you as a photographer have the control of both the quality of light, the quantity of light, and its direction to enhance your subject to its best advantage. As a result, it's far easier to achieve better images than just accepting the ambient lighting conditions, and you might say flash can achieve pictures that would be otherwise impossible. Now, whilst it's true that flash can be very destructive if used incorrectly, for example, you get very harsh shadows, you get bleached out colours, and you get a very unnatural light source in many instances. But when used correctly, you can get some fantastic images using a flash as a light source. However, the introduction of flash into your toolkit also poses significant challenges. There's new jargon to learn, like flash synchronisation speeds, first and second curtain, fill flash ratios, etc. However, once these are understood, it gives the pathway to giving you the opportunities of creating great images. And in this video, I'll be showing you some of those techniques. Now, even the basic rules of photography are challenged when we're using flash exposure. For example, the shutter speed of the camera controls the amount of ambient light exposure, and we can either enhance that or we can totally block it out by a suitable shutter speed. The aperture and flash duration are the principal components of giving the correct exposure, and I'll be showing you how to set these ratios in this video. Now, even if you don't currently have a dedicated flash gun, even using the pop-up flash you can achieve some great images if you just use a simple diffuser, and I'll be showing you how to use that in this video. In fact, I've just found a puffball fungus nearby. It's a bit early in the year for the majority of the fungus to appear. They're normally later October, early November, but I have found this one, which will give us the opportunity of capturing those images, and I'll show you the pop-up flash and an external flash gun. And I've also just captured a couple of images of a speckled wood very early morning on the dew here, so I managed to get a couple of images using the pop-up flash just to show you what's achievable by using just a pop-up flash on the camera alone. So let's go over to that puffball fungus and I'll set up and we'll take some shots and I'll show you how I've achieved the images. So here's the location for the puffballs. There's a couple of them there on the mound. It's in the shade of this tree and it's very bright behind, so it's given me quite a few issues trying to film this correctly, but hopefully you can see what we're doing in this video. Now I'm using the FZ 300 330 today, as that's ideal for this sort of picture outdoors. You've got lots of depth of field. Even if you're using F4, that's the equivalent of something like F16 on a full frame sensor camera. So I've got lots of depth of field. As usual, I'm using aperture priority mode and the lowest ISO, which is 100. I've got my aperture set to F5 in this instance. That's around about the sweet spot for the FZ 300 330 lens. So I'm going to take an ambient light shot first of all, and I'll take an establishing shot just to show the actual ambient conditions that the fungus is growing in. It's fortunate the sun has just gone in behind clouds, so the clouds are giving us a nice soft light, which is ideal for this type of subject. So here's the ambient conditions that the fungus is growing in. I'll just move in and we'll take a closer shot to show the detail of the textures of these puffballs. So now we'll take a picture using the pop-up flash, and to do that I'm using this little diffuser which clips into the hot shoe. I'll put a link to this in the video description below. They're available on Amazon and eBay and very cheap. You just slide into your hot shoe like so, and then you just pop up the flash, and that diffuses the light to stop you getting those harsh edge shadows. It gives you a little bit of a softening effect. For my first exposure, I'll just use the straightforward TTL metering that the camera provides. So it's looking at the flashlight coming back from the subject and then adjusting the flash power by varying its duration. So we'll take that shot, the same position as we did with the ambient light. And you can see that we've got a fairly decent exposure. Now, the ambient light exposure is currently 1/60th of a second to achieve the right exposure. But if I wanted to totally black out the ambient light and just use my flash, then I could switch to the manual mode and put a shutter speed of something like 1/500th. Now, we don't have to worry about flash synchronization speeds with our bridge cameras, as the shutter is actually in the lens. It's not like a mirrorless or DSLR where we've got a shutter to move out of the way. Here it's in the lens and can move very quickly, so we can use all of the mechanical shutter speeds to give us any flash duration. So I'm switching over to the manual mode. I'm keeping f5 and I'm going to set the shutter speed to 1/500th of a second. So that's 1/500th, totally underexposed for daylight exposure, but the flash will compensate for that. So that was the flash exposure with the daylight being totally eradicated by using a very fast shutter speed, which would totally underexpose the daylight image. But the flash is providing me direct light onto the subject, very little modelling, but it is giving me an acceptable picture, which might otherwise be impossible. I'm just going to increase the flash power to give a little bit of extra light on the subject. So there I will use flash adjust and I go from zero. I'm going to go to plus one EV. So we've got an extra amount of light coming from the flash unit, which should help this exposure. And that looks a little brighter. But our light is still directional from the front, doesn't give us any modelling on the subject, which would be nice because these are spherical objects. So I would like to switch to an external flash gun, and I'm going to trigger that remotely. It's going to be the Godox TT350O, which is my recommendation for Panasonic cameras at the moment. And I'm going to trigger that using the X-Pro O version of the transmitter, which gives you the Panasonic commands to fire the flash unit. So I'll switch over to an external flash and let's take some more pictures. So I've got the X-Pro trigger set up on the FZ300 here. Got it set so we're in TTL mode, so the camera is still determining the exposure. I normally use manual exposure, but for this sake I'm going to try using the TTL mode. I've got my flash gun and I've got the zoom set to 105mm, which gives me a more concentrated beam to give a brighter illumination. So I'm going to take the first shot, and what I want to try and do is simulate daylight. So I want to bring the flash over at something like 45 degrees to the subject and 45 degrees above it. And we'll take that first shot and look at the exposure. Focusing on the front of the puff balls. And we can see we've got some nice modelling behind now. It looks as though we've got a spherical object. If I just move a little bit further to the left, again, that's given some nice modelling. I'd like to increase the flash power, so I can do that by adjusting the flash output on this unit. So I'm going to put another plus one EV on there. So we've increased the flash power by 1 EV, so that means the duration will be slightly longer. So again, let's take that shot, and that's given a much better exposure. And I'll just change the composition so that the big puff ball is on the intersection of 2/3 to make the composition a little bit stronger. And that looks quite nice. Now, if I change the angle of illumination, if I bring it towards the camera, then that will simulate the effect of the on-camera flash, and we'll get this lack of modelling on the subject. So let me just take that shot for you. So you can see there's very little modelling to that light. So if you go over to 45 degrees and 45 degrees, then you get nice modelling on your subject. Well, that's it for part 6 of this tutorial. Hope you found that really useful. If you're a new viewer, please do click that subscribe button and the bell notification icon, and then you'll be notified when I upload new videos in the channel. Also, check out my photography blog, and I'll put a link to that in the video description below. Lots more information on Panasonic Lumix bridge cameras and photography in general, so please do check that out. And if you look on the homepage, there's an application form to join my newsletter group, and that goes out to 3,000 users now every month. It's more than a newsletter. It is a technical publication in many respects, and it's a way of saying thanks for your subscription. So do check that out, and if you haven't already completed that, just fill in the application form and it gives me the authority to send you emails. So until the next video, which will be again on landscapes, but this time shooting waterfalls and seascapes with those long time exposures to create dreamy water-like images. So until then, thanks again for watching. Please do take care, and I hope to see you all in the next one. Goodbye for now.